There is a major push underway to bring locally grown and more nutritious food to our nation's school lunch programs.
To do that, it will cost more money. President Obama is proposing spending an additional $1 billion per year when the Child Nutrition Act comes up for reauthorization later this year. Today, an undersecretary for the U.S. Department of Agriculture heard from people in Maine who administer school lunch programs about what works and what doesn't. News editor Chris Rose reports.
It's lunchtime, and in school cafeterias across Maine, students have more healthier choices than their parents did when they attended school. But food service directors and nutritionists agree we can and must do better. There is growing concern over a possible link between high childhood obesity rates in Maine and school lunch programs. Congresswoman Chellie Pingree is backing the president's plan to raise nutritional standards for school lunches. She says lunch programs can achieve higher standards by giving children more local and healthier choices.
We heard a lot from food service directors saying we would like to do more of that, but the system has been skewed to process food. Some of them said we don't even have adequate equipment to store fresh fruits and vegetables.
Pingree hosted this roundtable that brought together school lunch experts from around Maine. USDA Undersecretary Kevin Concannon was here to listen. He says he will bring the concerns and ideas he heard back to Washington with him.
Does it make sense to truck some of these foods 3,000 miles across the country if they could be grown in a local area? So farm to school is one of the initiatives we're promoting. Know your farmer, know your food. We want people to eat healthier.
People who run the school lunch program say they would love to provide more local and healthier options, but costs are a concern. They say food prices continue to rise, with the healthier choices often costing more.
We're doing more fresh fruits and vegetables, more whole grains, but all those cost more. And the funding has not gone up a whole lot in the last few years. So that's a big concern.
A $1 billion increase in these tight times is a tough sell, but supporters of the increase say in the long run, healthier kids will mean lower costs for our health care system. In Buxton, Chris Rose, News Center.